Now it is time for some home design tips from the amazing Hamish Dodd, who is joining us in the Harvey Norman Lounge, and it's a bit of a whitewash this morning, Hamish.
Nice.
Yeah. Thank you very much. I'm here all night, try the fish.
That's right. We're going to talk about white, and that may sound overly simplistic, but there are a lot of them, and you want to get the correct white when you're going to be repainting, because painting's not cheap, even if you're doing it yourself, so you want to get stuck in and get it right from the start.
Okay, so I walk into a resine shop, I go, I want a white. What are they going to say?
They're going to show you something like this, first of all, which is the whites and some of the basic neutrals.
Right.
And if that's not enough for you, they're going to hand you the whites and neutrals fan deck there, which Mel's lovely going to display for us there.
Hang on.
Well, so that is a lot of bases of white, isn't it?
There are. So there are a lot of whites and there are a lot of neutrals in the range as well. Now, all of them are going to have a different base.
Mm-hmm.
You can get a card like this, which will show you.
Okay.
And the most important part is the beginning of it. In this case, it's BR, so that's brown. Okay, so it's going to have a slightly browner base. There's a code on every single colour.
So many codes.
Not just the names.
That doesn't look like white to me.
No, no, that moves up into the neutrals. But when you move right to the bottom, we've got 8th Canterbury Clay.
Okay.
Okay, so that becomes our whiter neutral.
Okay, so how do we choose which white to actually pick?
Okay, there are always key indicators in the house. So if you're starting from scratch and there's nothing in it, we can pick a white based on what you want the room to feel like. If you're renovating, there's going to be things such as kitchens to look at,
yes,
colours of existing cabinetry, perhaps splashbacks. There's carpet if you're keeping the existing carpet. There's tiles and stuff like that. That's what's going to lead us down the path to find a white that is going to do what you want but still match what you've already got.
And not be too clinical. So when we say white, that's white, isn't it?
Yeah, that's correct. So that's white, and these here are three other whites. I'm going to use these two because I've used them for a client recently.
Yeah.
He wanted white.
Mm-hmm.
I said no.
He wanted this.
He wanted white because that's what people picture in their heads.
Yes, crisp and clean and beautiful and...
Correct. And I mean, you can see the difference in the colour right there. So what we did was we used Wan White, okay, which is slightly greyer. Once it was up on the walls and everything was painted, he walked in and he said, crikey, I'm glad you chose the white, because otherwise we would have had a hospital. And even then, it still looks really white.
Mm. Right. So different bases, different moods?
Different bases, different moods. Well, I mean, it depends. I'm not a huge fan of the creams. I've always preferred a cleaner white. So people will know colours such as alabaster, black white, white pointer. We've got samples like that. There you go.
So that looks gorgeous, but I've got kids and I feel that that might be, you know, how am I going to maintain that with rubby fingers?
That probably leads on to our next thing, which is, you know, sort of talking about gloss levels and bits and pieces.
Yes.
Okay. So how I like to do the walls, I like to do my walls in space coat because it's nice and durable and hard and you can really get stuck in and clean it well.
Oh, I recognise that name, yeah, because that's my entire house.
You don't want to do it too flat on the walls because the flatter the paint, the harder it is to clean. And you may have noticed on people's ceilings, which are always painted flat, someone's had fly spots and they've gone up there and scrubbed the ceiling. It polished the surface of the paint.
Yeah.
That's why you see the marks. So try not to scrub your ceilings is what I'm getting at. I personally, I like skirtings, window frames done in a high gloss.
Yes.
Okay. I like my doors done in a satin. And I like my walls done in a semi-gloss, or a lower sheen, something like space coat.
So satin, that's wipeable as well, isn't
it? Yeah, satin is. I mean, you don't want to see doors that sparkle at you. Then you don't want them to be too bright, but you want a satin, so it's slightly more than the walls.
Okay, and do you have the same white for your skirtings as you do for the wall, or can you mix it up?
Some people like to, and I'm okay with that, but I believe if we're changing gloss levels, we can change it fractionally. But to simply do it, if you want to, Wan White, for example, for the walls, and I used half Wan White, so it's a very subtle difference, but you do notice it. And what that ends up giving you is a white wall, but you've got a contrast against the slightly lighter ceiling, so it feels like it's got a little bit of depth.
Okay, or we could do what I've done and leave things semi-renovated for a while and have them unpainted for quite some substantial amount of time.
Do you have test pot pictures all over the wall?
Yeah, I do. Top five tips then, very, very quickly.
Okay, top five tips. Okay, firstly, when you choose your white, you don't want to go too white because it's going to take more coats to cover.
Right.
Be prepared, of course, that you may have to pay for an extra coat of paint to go on. Most they'll quote on two coats, you're probably going to need three.
Mm-hmm.
Check the roller type that's going to be used. Ask them if you don't like a stippled, rougher finish, you need a finer sort of Dacron sleeve roller to give you a smoother finish.
Okay.
Prep work is key. So if your walls need prep work, you're going to have to accept that has to be done.
Okay. I think that was only four, wasn't it? But they're still good points.
Hey, who's counting?
That's right. There are a lot of whites to count as well, but the team at Resine always make it easier. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
For more information, you can head to resine.co.nz.